Hey, what's going on, friends and family? Welcome back to another episode of BKL Reviews. And today, man, I am so excited to finally see this pair in person. To be honest with you guys, I was on the fence about this, and this will actually be a second in my collection. But before we get started with any of that, I definitely want to encourage everyone to hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed the video and you enjoyed the content. And also, please show your love and support by hitting that subscribe button that's in the lower right-hand corner. With all that being said, and no further ado, let's get into the review. Well, as you can see, this is something that I purchased from Nike.com. I was fortunate enough to actually secure this pair through the site. So let's check it out. I was very surprised that they sold out, but I have a feeling that sometimes Nike put stuff on its site and then they say it's sold out, but then a couple hours later you start seeing sizes popping back up. I think Nike is doing a lot of nonsense that they shouldn't be doing, but you know, that's just my personal opinion. You already know no review would be complete without for the receipt police. That might give it away of what we're doing today. So as you can see, it does come in that new red Nike box. We've seen this box on two other reviews. Well, I haven't posted them as of yet, but two other releases. Honestly, I do like this box a lot. You have your bright red box with your black Nike brand, and pretty much they just did the box opposite color. Instead of being black with red, it's red with black. So let's check it out. Today, we're doing a review on a pair of Air Jordan 1 mids. These are the Fearless NA. Style code is CU2805100, and the color is Muslim Black Varsity Red Royal. As you can see, you have your brand in here on the lid. And the actual paper, pretty cool. It says fierce is often like illusions. Then you also have your card that comes with it. Limits like fears are often just an illusion. Sorry about that. That's what it says on the tissue paper. And then you also have your white tissue paper. Okay, put all this away for you guys. Definitely nice. I was on the fence, like I said earlier, mainly because this is a mid and I honestly have two pairs in my collection. Actually, I'm lying. I have one pair in my collection. The first pair that I had that was a mid was, I think it was the Love of the Game, the black and yellow pair, if I'm not mistaken, or the For the Love. I'm not really sure exactly what the name was. I purchased that through Foot Locker, but I actually ended up returning it, mainly because I didn't like mids. But this one right here, this one is nice. If you're not familiar with this sneaker, this is the Air Jordan 1 mid. This is done by Blue the Great, who is an LA artist, who is known for doing artworks like the Boys in the Hood piece, his Bubble piece. But he's most notable known for his collaboration he did with Kendrick Lamar. I think it was at the BET Awards. He did the American flag on the side of the car. So I am definitely happy that Jordanbrand did a collaboration with this young man. So let's get into this sneaker. First off, the most noticeable difference on this sneaker is the color and the material. So to be honest with you guys, it does have some nice materials on here. On the wings logo here, you do have a nice grade of suede right there. And then the wings logo is actually sewn in black. You also have more suede here in the high ankle collar in blue. And then you also have that Chanel Nike swoosh here that's normally on your varsity leather jackets. And the white mid panel or side panel is corduroy. Definitely like that a lot. It makes everything kind of goes together as well. Along the lace holes here, you do have more suede. You have the red and the green. And then as we get to the toe box area, you have that blue, or the mud guard, sorry, blue. And then you have that yellow on the toe box. You have your sail midsole and your black outsole. As we go to the toe box, as you can see, like I said earlier, you have that yellowish suede here. The suede is pretty decent. I have to say the material on here is very nice. I'm glad Jordanbrand didn't give us some trashy material here on the toe box. As you can see, you have your black laces, but it also comes with a second pair that is more like a white lace. As we go to the top of the tongue, you have your brand in here with the Jordan Jumpman logo, and it has the air in red, green, and blue. As we go to the lateral side, it's pretty much the same makeup. You get to see the materials a lot better. Like I said earlier, the materials on here is very nice. As we go to the back of the heel, there you go as well. I do like the fact that they put his little brand in here that says blue. There you go right there. And your red, yellow, blue, and green. And if I'm not mistaken, these are pretty much your basic color whenever you are a painter or whatever and you need to do your palette. These are your basic colors that you would normally use to create all your colors. So I do like the fact that they was able to incorporate that as well. As we go to the insole, let's see what it has here. If I'm not mistaken, the insole is pretty cool as well from the photos that I've seen. Sometimes they glue these things in to the point where you're unable to. Let me see if I could get it from this one. Come on. All right, so they're pretty glued in there, but the insole is like one of his artwork pieces. Is like painted balls in different colors. And it says sphere, and it's crossed out. I'm not sure if the camera's picking it up, but that's the best that I can do. I would have liked to take the insole out, but unfortunately, it's pretty much in there. As you can see, it does have a little wings logo here in blue. It says sphere as well, but then that's crossed out. And then on the other side, it has the same saying, limits like fear are often just an illusion. And as we go to the outsole, it's just standard Jordan 1 outsole, solid black, your Nike brand in here, and your pop-up stars here along the forefront of the sneaker. Like I said earlier, guys, this was a pair that I really didn't expect a lot from. I didn't really expect them to sell out as fast as they did, but like I said earlier, I have a feeling Nike does that. They make you think that a sneaker sold out, and then all of a sudden, a couple hours later, you're getting notifications that sizes are available. But I am happy I was able to add this to my collection. I do like the fact that they collaborated with a decent guy. I don't know him personally, but I know some of his stuff and I seen some of his work. So I do like the fact that he was able to put his touch on a classic silhouette. It would have been great if it would have been a high, but you know, I'm not gonna complain about that. Let me know what you think. Is this a pair that you was actually going out for? Is this a pair that you added to your collection? Please leave your comments below and we can discuss. Definitely want to thank everyone once again for tuning in to another video of BKO Reviews. Like I said earlier, guys, if you enjoyed the video and you enjoyed the content, only thing that I ask is for you to hit the thumbs up button. It surely goes a long way. And also subscribe to the channel. It's the best way of staying up to date with the most recent content. You can also follow me on these social media platforms. And once again, I want to thank everyone for tuning in to another video of BKO Reviews.